The sea princess. The sun sparkled on the distant sea and made the sand hot under their bare feet. Sarah and Jamie trailed their spades in the sand, leaving wavy doodles behind them as they strolled along the beach contentedly. They came upon a jumble of rocks just by the edge of the sea and started to explore the glistening rock pools.
Fabulous shells! Look at this one, Jamie. Pass it over there.
Thanks.
Shh! Jamie, can you hear something?
I can hear the sea and a load of seagulls.
No, there's something else, like someone singing.
You're right. There's a girl in the water just over there.
Oh, yeah, with really long hair. Her top looks like it's made of wet seaweed.
Maybe it is. If you ask me, she looks a bit strange.
Let's go and say hello anyway. Can't do any harm.
Okay.
Hello?
Hello?
We heard you singing.
Yes, I'm famous for my singing. No one can hear it and remain unmoved. My name's Marina. Princess Marina. You may kiss my hand.
Oh, it's a bit cold and wet. Kind of like a fish.
This is Jamie. Just plain Jamie. Not Prince Jamie or anything. And I'm his sister Sarah.
Did you see the prince on the beach?
Which prince would that be?
Oh, the prince, stupid. I don't know his name. Oh, he's young and handsome. And I love him. Oh, but he doesn't even know I exist.
How come? I thought all princes and princesses knew each other.
Oh, it's a long story.
Well, go on then. Tell us it then.
Well, there was a great storm one night, last winter. I went up to the surface to see what I could find.
Up to the surface?
Yes. I found a ship wrecked on the rocks. Most of the mortals had already drowned, but the prince was still alive. I tied him to a piece of wreckage with my hair and towed him to a safe inlet.
Was he all right?
Well, he was unconscious, but I watched over him all night until some mortals found him at dawn. Oh, he looked so helpless and handsome lying there. I just fell in love with him. We were destined for each other.
So why don't you just go up to him and tell him it was you who rescued him? Introduce yourself, you know.
You don't understand. Merpeople can't mix with mortals.
Merpeople?
I can't leave the sea. And he never comes down to the shore. That's why I come here and sing. In the hope that he'll hear me and come and investigate.
Maybe we can help.
Yes. You're mortals. Perhaps you can help. Come, I'll take you home with me.
Huh? She's got a tail.
Like a big fish.
Well, what are you waiting for?
You really are a mermaid.
Oh, I'm not a mermaid. I'm a merprincess. I'm taking you to see my palace. Are you coming or not?
We can't come with you underneath the sea. We'll drown.
Oh, yes, I forgot. Here, I've got some magic beads from the sea witch, in case I needed them for my prince. Put them on, and they'll turn you into merpeople for the day. Oh, hurry up, or we'll be late for dinner.
All right.
Are you sure this is going to be okay? I don't fancy drowning.
Yes, yes. You better be quick.
Here it goes, then.
If you're sure.
Positive.
I'm coming.
Hey, I can breathe underwater.
She doesn't have to swim fast.
Oh, come on. Can't you move any quicker than that?
My legs seem to be glued together.
It makes swimming a bit difficult.
Oh, that's because you haven't got legs, silly. Merpeople have tails.
Oh, you're right. Does that make me a merboy?
Look, use your tail. Swing it from side to side, like this.
You're right, it works.
It's a lot faster than swimming with legs on.
Now you've got the hang of it. Do get a move on.
Okay, lead the way. Is this the palace you were talking about?
Yes. It's made of pink coral, you know, with amber windows and a roof of cockle shells.
Which keep opening and shutting.
And each one's got a precious stone inside.
What do you think?
This is some place.
You'd never guess something like this could be under the sea.
Those porpoises either side of the door, are they bouncers?
They make sure nobody swims into the palace who shouldn't, if that's what you mean.
And tons of exotic-looking fish. It's all so colourful.
Come and meet my mother. Is she the Mer Queen?
Marina! There you are, you naughty girl. We've had to keep dinner waiting. And who are your friends?
Sorry, Mama. This is Sarah.
Hello.
And Jamie.
Hi.
I found them playing near the shore.
I told you not to spend so much time near the shore. It doesn't do to be seen by mortals.
Sorry, Mama.
Hurry up and comb your hair now. Stefan is here for dinner.
Yes, Mama. Sarah, you come with me. I'll comb your hair too.
What about me?
We'll wait here until we swim down.
All right. Don't be long.
You've got lovely hair, Marina. I don't think mine could ever grow that long.
I'll do yours. Keep still.
Marina?
Mm?
Who's Stefan?
Oh, he's my cousin. My parents want me to marry him.
Don't you want to?
Well, I told you. I want to marry my prince. Anyway, I couldn't marry someone like Stefan. I've known him forever. We practically shared the same cradle net.
Yes. I can see how that might be a problem.
Is my tiara on straight?
Yes, you look great. Come on, I'm going to meet everybody. And I think Jamie's probably getting impatient by now. Probably thinking about his stomach.
I don't know about you, but I'm feeling really hungry.
What do you think they eat down here? Fish?
Not sure. Wouldn't that make them cannibals, seeing as how they're half fish themselves?
Yeah, you got a point. Hey, do you reckon that old man's her dad?
Old Merman, you mean? He looks really kind.
And the young bloke in the seaweedy bow tie. I suppose that's Stefan.
Must be. Let's swim over and meet them all.
Great. That means we can start on the food too. I'm starving.
I thought you might be.
She's a naughty little one's arms.
Marina?
Yes, what is it?
After dinner's over, Marina, you must show your friends around the palace, especially the treasure room.
Treasure room? What kind of treasure?
Oh, you'll love it. It's full of jewelry and old coins, and all sorts of things that used to belong to mortals. They're so careless, always letting their ships sink down here with all their precious belongings still in them.
Sounds exciting.
Rather large, fellow. It's very exciting.
Down here at the bottom of the sea. Loads and loads of fabulous jewellery.
Are they gold coins over there?
Of course. Look, here, have one.
Thanks. Hey, look, it's a Spanish doubloon.
A what?
A Spanish doubloon. I saw one of these in a museum once. They must be worth a bit.
You know, Marina, Stefan's not that bad.
Oh, you don't have to marry him.
He looks like he's really fond of you. Couldn't take his eyes off you at dinner.
Oh, too bad. Look, will you two help me tomorrow?
Sure. What do you want us to do?
I'm going to see the sea witch. I want her to change me into a mortal so that I can go and find my prince. But it's going to be dangerous. You still want to come?
Yes, of course. Isn't there going to be a slight problem, though? Aren't we only merpeople just for the day? What happens if we suddenly get our legs back when we're still at the bottom of the sea?
Oh, that'll be all right. We'll get up really early. Then I'll take you back up to the surface. We'd better swim to bed now.
Just let me have another look at all these coins. They're brilliant.
Actually, I'd better get something to take to the sea witch as a present. Soften her up a bit.
How about this silver necklace with the emeralds in it?
Yes, that'll do nicely. She'll love that. Now, we'd better get a good night's sleep. It's not going to be an easy journey.
Was a terrifying journey. First, they crossed a sea desert where nothing grew, but giant whirlpools rotated like mill wheels, trying to suck everything down into their murky depths. Then there was a swamp of boiling, hot, bubbling mud that threw up spouts of scorching spray. At last, they saw the sea witch's hut.
Last bit coming up. This is the worst of all. These things are half animal, half plant. They try and grab you with their long, slimy arms. Unfortunately, most of them have already caught hold of something and don't have a free hand. Don't stop for anything. And keep away from those grasping fingers.
Don't worry. We'll keep moving. We don't fancy being their next meal.
There's her hut. You see? It's made out of bones and thatched with the hair of drowned sailors.
How about those water snakes? They have pets.
Yes. Shh, now. Wait outside.
Oh, it's you again. What do you want this time?
Please, Sea Witch, I'd like you to turn me into a mortal so I can go on dry land and find my prince.
Oh, you're a very silly girl. But then in my experience, most princesses are very silly girls.
Please, Sea Witch, will you do it?
You'd much better stay in the sea where you belong and marry that nice young mare Prince Stefan.
Oh, please.
Oh. What have you brought me this time?
Oh, look. A silver necklace with emeralds.
Not bad. That came from a queen's treasure, I'll be bound.
Will you do it, then?
I can only give you one day. Even my magic can't do more than that. The only way you can become a proper mortal is to get a mortal prince to fall in love with you and marry you. And much good may that do you.
Oh, thank you, Sea Witch. Thank you.
Here. Take this bottle. If you drink this, you'll become a mortal. But as soon as the sun goes down, you'll change back into a mare person again. What are you doing?
Well, I'm going to drink it, like you said I should.
Oh, don't drink it now, you silly girl. Do you want to drown? Wait until you're on the surface.
Oh, I see.
Oh, swim along now. I've had enough of silly princesses for one day.
Yes, thank you. Come on, you two. We're going up to the surface, to the land of the mortals.
Good job, too.
I'm looking forward to getting my legs back.
Not that it hasn't been fun down here.
I'll be a mortal myself soon. Quick, quick! No time to lose!
Hey, wait for us!
Potion now.
Here goes.
Ugh. Ugh, it doesn't taste too good. Look, your tail's falling off.
What are these? Legs. Ooh, they feel funny.
At least you'll be able to walk now.
You'll probably have to help me at first. I've never done this before.
You may be able to walk, but I don't see how we can. We've still got these tails.
Well, just take your necklaces off.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about them.
Oh, I feel a bit wobbly.
Me too. We'll have to bring each other up.
Take me to the prince's palace.
Okay, you put one foot in front of the other, like this. See?
Oh, you'll soon get the hang of it.
I hope so.
This must be the palace. How are we going to get past those guards?
Leave it to me.
What is your business at the palace?
I want to see the prince.
Oh, yes, little missy. And why might that be?
I am not a little missy. I'm a prince.
Yes, you are quite a pretty missy. You and the 49 others. Step this way.
Why do you want to see His Highness?
I saved his life when his ship was wrecked.
Why do you all do it?
Do what?
Another damsel who saved the prince's life!
What are they all laughing about?
That must be the prince, on his throne, over there.
He looks really bored.
Oh, come here, damsel. Let me look at you.
Doesn't look like he recognizes her.
Not bad. Not bad at all. Well, you're a lot better looking than the last one. Pity you walk so clumsily.
He would too if he'd been a fish until this morning.
So tell me, how did you rescue me?
Please, sire. I was out swimming on the surface. In the sea, that night. And I saw your wrecked ship. You were clinging to a piece of wreckage, almost unconscious. And I brought you to the shore.
Not a very likely story, is it? Can't you do better than that? I can't see many damsels going for a swim in that storm. The waves were as high as mountains.
Don't you remember anything about being rescued, sire?
The only thing I can remember very dimly is somebody singing. A kind of unearthly, haunting song. Someone said I might have been rescued by a mermaid. But you're not a mermaid, are you?
Maybe not. But I can sing. May I sing for you, sire?
Oh, very well. We shall have music after dining. Take them away and feed them. Well, that's what they've come here for, really. The scruffy lot.
Thank you, sire.
Well, Marina, you found your prince at last.
Yes.
He might be a prince, but he's not very charming, is he?
Do you think he'll fall in love with you when he hears you sing?
I don't know. I'm not so sure I want him to anymore.
Can't say I blame you.
Silence! His Highness wishes to speak!
The damsel may sing for me now.
Oh, yes, sire.
Well?
La, da, 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 da.
Oh dear, he doesn't look too impressed.
Well, I don't think much of that. You're certainly not a patch on the mermaid I heard that night. I'm getting tired of all these damsels claiming to have rescued me, so I'm issuing a decree.
What?
In future, any damsel who claims to have rescued me and didn't will be thrown into the sea from the top of the highest cliff. And to make it quite clear I mean what I say, we'll start with you.
No!
Take her away. If you're such a good swimmer as you claim to be, it shouldn't be too much of a hardship.
Come on, little missy, come on, you're coming with me.
Poor old Marina. Come on, Jamie, we'd better go and follow. Make sure she's all right.
How can she be? If you're thrown into the sea from a great height, you go down so deep, you drown before you can reach the surface.
We've got to save her.
There's not a lot we can do at the moment.
But we'd better go all the same. There might be something we can do to help. Come on.
There they are, about to chuck her over the edge. Great, what do we do now?
We'll just have to hope she gets her tail back in time. The sun's just going down. She might just make it. Yeah. She hasn't come back up to the surface.
Let's go down to the beach. We might be able to find her.
Good idea.
Can't see her, can you? No. But isn't there Stefan over there?
You're right. Hey, Stefan!
Where's Marina? What's happened to her? Where is she? My precious pearl.
Here.
Marina.
Stefan. Oh, Stefan. It's so so good to see you. It was horrible.
Hey, you changed back into a mermaid.
A mer-princess, you mean? Yes, my tail came back as the sun went down, just as I hit the water.
Oh, my precious. Did you find your prince?
Yes, I did. And he was horrible. I can't think what I ever saw in him. But he certainly isn't my prince. You're my prince.
So you don't want to be immortal after all?
No, I do not. It was horrible being immortal. I felt as if I was walking on knives, and I couldn't breathe properly. I felt stifled. Stefan?
Yes, Princess?
Take me home.
I will. I will. But say goodbye to your friends.
Goodbye, Sarah and Jamie. I'll never forget you.
Thank you for looking after her. Whatever happened, she seems to have got over wanting to leave the Sea Kingdom.
You can thank the Prince for that.
Well, goodbye. And if you're ever down our way again, do drop in. You'll always be welcome.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye, Marina. Bye, Stefan.
Hold my hand, Stefan. Ready to dive?
Ready. One, two, three, go.
What are we doing now? Fancy walking back up the beach?
Yeah, why not? Jamie, did we really go down under the sea, or did we just dream all that?
No, it can't have been a dream.
What makes you so sure?
Because it's here somewhere. Oh, here it is.
What?
That coin, the Spanish doubloon.
You still got it?
Yes. And you can't bring a souvenir back from a dream, can you?
That's true. Still, no one's ever going to believe us.
I'll have to remember to bring an underwater camera next time we go down to the beach.
Hey, that's a good idea.
It's getting dark. We'd better be getting back.
Yeah. Race you!
Hey, that's not fair! Wait for me!
The music in The Sea Princess is taken from Debussy's La Mer. In From Dawn to Midday at Sea, the sun breaks through after a powerful crescendo. The strings play gentle lapping sounds. Oboe and violin play together. Cellos play a rhythmic dance melody. Of play of the waves, the sea is calm. Over the subdued sounds of harp and celeste, the flute and clarinet give out a long sigh. The harps play sweeping glissandos or gliding notes. The violins race upwards while trumpets add a sparkle of sunshine as each wave breaks into foam at its crest. The cellos contribute an important melody of their own. Swell, greater and broader than all the others, rises in a giant crescendo, only to fade away to nothing. out of the turbulence, a trumpet tune emerges to begin the dialogue of the wind and the sea, like a ship suddenly appearing far off on the horizon. A new woodwind tune appears, introducing a calmer mood. Trumpet tune is played pizzicato, with plucking notes, by the cello and bassoon. With a great crash, the sea rises in full force. These are just some of the highlights of La Mer by Claude Debussy. You are bound to discover more every time you listen.